How should I begin this? I'm just so offended. Yeah, how am I even mentioned about all these?
Cola.
Cause I just bought
you. Yo, you.
So, maybe like two or three in a row.
Nah, but that might be what you wanted to be. Let me tell you.
You think of my other black shorts that got palm trees on it. Without aliens and UFOs. And saucers.
Shit. So the same two.
What's up?
Huh? The same two?
Yep.
This shit is on me, man. I ain't even mad at you. I'm just saying, they gonna roast me. They clean, right? At least they clean, right?
Yep.
You ain't re-wearing.
Stop, they clean.
You ain't out here in the streets re-
They clean.
I do need the marijuana in the papers. Oh, Dale got marijuana, so I just need the paper. Please, thank you. What do you want to talk about, Dale? We ain't technically started yet.
Let's see. We were talking about quite a few things a couple days ago.
Yeah, I know we were supposed to talk about. First, we got. I remember that deeper layer about the blind side that I forgot to talk about.
We can bring that back up.
Talk about that. In that, but I was gonna save that for a little bit later. But then we got
it's a good topic to talk about
the superposition.
I know you don't always have to talk about current events, but it's good because
it's a good ongoing
current event right now.
It's good. Let me tell you, when we recorded that episode, the day we recorded that episode, if I was a master editor and I had a whole team behind me and all that shit, bro, we would have been able to drop an episode talking about that shit before Joe Budden, but. He talked about it, and it's out. And by the time this gets out, this will air, Saturday? 2 weeks from now? So. But either way, I noticed that the public, they was usually talking about that story. They'd be talking about it on the surface. They only talking about Michael Orr and the blind side. They don't know about how all those kids... I ain't gonna go through all of it right now. But then we can talk about that. We can talk about... the superposition. We ended on that last time.
Oh yeah.
Talking about what that is. I got that and whatever, you know, current events and I got if you want me to get into my question bag, hold up. Don't let me get to asking Dale questions. You ain't gonna like these questions, Dale. You ain't gonna like them. Say not. What's your most toxic female experience? Like, that's crazy. Like, you're not gonna like that.
What's the question, I'm sorry?
What's your most toxic female experience?
Oh, you already know that.
I don't.
The succubus.
Oh, shit. Well, yeah, well, we could talk about that. We can talk about how some people don't need addresses. Some people don't need addresses, bro. Like you give them the address to something and they get more confused. Like, you just need to tell them where to go type shit.
How are you going to find out where you're going without an address?
Some people don't need an address. You know what I mean?
Like, what are you going to sit? Like meet me at the McDonald's or meet me at Walmart?
They got better chance finding you with that way. Where did this topic come from?
You watched something the other night.
Nah, I ain't watching nothing. Wasn't the other night. I came with this in the car. That was funny, too.
That wasn't
fun. Yeah, you spaced out.
But I mean, what's so difficult? You pop that in Google Maps, and Google Maps does everything else for you.
Some people find a way to complicate it. That's all I'm gonna say.
Okay.
Some people find a way to complicate it. Complicate it. To find a way. Microphone check.
Like it's kind of a new thing to me. People getting lost nowadays with a smartphone. It's like almost impossible.
It's not about lost. It's about you don't need the address. You can come to here, but you don't need the address. You can come, but you having an address leads to so much more shit than if you didn't have an address and you just came and was always escorted or brought with somebody of the thing.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, some people don't need the address.
Okay.
Because if they get the address, then that means so-and-so so too got the address,
too. They just following the word-of-mouth caravan.
Well, they give everybody the address. Now everybody got the address.
So they just follow the caravan.
Don't give everybody the Addy.
Or they're just following somebody else who has the address.
But rather that than you have it yourself and then do with it what you please. It's sad. You know what I thought too? Walking around one time on acid, walking down the street in a really pristine neighborhood in Ashburn, Virginia.
What?
I noticed all the houses are exactly the same. And it was weird how like clockwork, everybody went in and out the house at the same time. Everybody was playing outside at the same time. Everybody went in and it was just like lights out. It was like, wow, that's just how, like, if God was Uncle Sam or America just looking down on, they'd be happy, like, yeah, that's how I like life going. You know what I mean? Shut lights out at 8 p.m. late, yeah.
That's the way it should be.
Yeah. But I also had the thought that people are very, very private with their information, but your information is public. Your address is technically public. All a nigga got to do is be on your street. Look at your damn street. Look at your address. And the nigga got your address. All this idea that somebody got to hack you and take your information. But your information is information. It's out.
Anybody can find your address from your license plate.
How you live, you know, is exposed. We live exposed.
True.
So, you know, even if he don't got the address, you know what I mean, he's still gonna find a way to come, ain't he?
It's hard to hide with the internet.
Hard to hide. I ain't hiding though. What I'm hiding for?
I'm the same.
That's what I'm saying. But yeah, we could talk about that. I'm gonna talk about something that I don't know if you can relate to, Dale.
What's that?
Sometimes when you black somewhere, or you working somewhere, or you even just having fun somewhere, just being black, you know, it's a whole thing. I don't know if you know that. Do you know that? He ain't talking. He on a podcast. He ain't gonna talk.
I was somewhat aware.
Okay, so it's a thing being black sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you go sometimes when you go somewhere and you're like the first one. Or not the first, or like one of the only, or you know, you're outnumbered. And then another black person shows up. It gets weird. Why? Like, why does it become a thing?
What are you saying? Like, it's awkward?
Not even awkward. It's an imposed, it's like a forced on you relationship. It's a forced on you click, almost. Like, now everybody else is like, they, you know what I mean? They, those two, you know, like, hold on. I did nothing but be black. You know what I mean? I just showed up. I was working. I was cool. You know what I mean? I'm black. You know what I mean? I'm doing me. But then another black person showed up that was like, no, the other black guy. No. You and him. Like, everything is together now. We go to break, like, yo, you're not going to go on break with me? Are you going to leave a nigga out here hanging like
like this?
I'm like, hold up. So I gotta stick with the black dude. No matter who this nigga is. Who knows who this guy is?
No bullshit.
Then the funny thing is the I feel like some black people do not look at other black people as competition because they're black. And it's a self-hate thing. They think in their mind the only real competition is to achieve whiteness or conquer somebody Caucasian. They don't believe... They see us as nothing to them. And it's almost like some black people, I think it's because you're like... You're so black... that you don't even know what blackness is. You know what I mean? Like, whatever happened to blackness, the trauma, the effects of that, hit you so hard that you don't even, you know, I don't know. What you think about competition? Do you think it's healthy
yeah.
in life?
Yeah,
in general, amongst humans?
Depending on the context of what you're talking about, but yeah, I mean... That's the guiding nature and force in sports.
Can you expound?
I mean,
on how important would you know?
Yeah.
Competition.
People show up to watch professional teams practice. You know, it's not that exciting though. They really want to see. They want to see people who are at their best compete, go against other people at their best.
And is that a nature thing? Because I feel like nature at some point too wants us to compete to achieve greatness, ultimate greatness.
Excuse me, pardon. Well, yeah, I mean, shit. I mean, there's competition everywhere in life. You need to understand and try to thrive in these environments to try to be successful. I mean, I don't know what to say else to say, like.
What does that say to you when a black person feel like, because I'm black, I'm not competition to them?
What do you mean by that?
Oh, he'll never make it because he black. You know what I mean? Like, black people think like that, too. That's what I think. I think it's some black people that think like
that. Get out of here. Stop!
You feel me, though? That's a crazy thing.
I mean... I don't know. You know me. I don't really feed into or buy into labels. You know,
you
what I'm
gotta feed into or buy into nothing. I'm asking you about a conversation, especially if I'm your friend and I'm telling you, you saying you're aware that black people go through this thing. It's a thing all the time, and I'm talking about this thing with you. I'm not looking for anything. First of all, I'm just potting, but I'm trying to get to.
I'm just in general. It's a hard. Topic for a white man to be commenting.
You know, I want your thoughts. Because your thoughts matter because, in my mind, look, white thoughts matter. To me, because you live a life without that. And I feel like to live a life with that, your goal is to always try to achieve to live a life without that. What they call, and it might be a racist thing that racist saying, get that monkey off your back or whatever it is. Like, always got something on you for no reason. I think that is a black thing, and I don't think it's even a black thing. I think it's a people thing, because people do this to people, like you said, with labels. But I think that it's like, it's something that we all have in tandem to where you should be able to see straight, you know, with me. And I should be able to see straight with you. Oh, shit. That motherfucker was big.
That was a big one?
That was big, bro.
That wasn't a hornet, was it?
Pause. That was definitely a hornet.
That motherfucker's maybe out of my neck.
Worst hornets.
Oh, really? Man, me too, man. That big-ass hornets, man.
Hornets.
Shit. You thought dealing with yellow jackets or wasps were bad.
Hornets. Nets for whores. Catch a whore with a net. $9.99. Hornet.
Oh, man.
I don't know, man. I don't know. You gotta try shit, man. And I think I tried to talk about it with you, I guess.
I don't know, man. You know, it's topics I always want to talk about.
Yeah, but
I like to talk a little bit about, like,
I do. I'm just to close what I was saying. We're about to lose light anyway. You probably can't even see us that well, and it's all Dell's fault, folks. If you ever want to know why the pod is late, the pod is fucking dark. That's your man.
Holla at your boy.
Holla at your boy. The one, the only, great, the GOAT, the God, the legend.
I would like to talk a little bit about the what's going on, like the writer's strike.
Yeah, 1 second. I just wanted to close it.
Okay.
I was going to say, I do want an articulation from you on some sort of empathetic way of understanding or trying to understand how that could get in the way of maybe even our relationship or us doing normal things and stuff. Like, that black issue does affect me no matter whether I wanted to or not. You know what I mean?
Well, I respect that.
And I just feel like with you, at some point, I ain't gonna force you to say nothing powerful. I ain't trying to tell you to change the world. I'm asking you just to empathize and talk through some of these things with me that I have to deal with, bro. Because as a friend, who the fuck else am I gonna talk to?
I'm not trying to avoid the subject.
So he's like, I'm white, I can't be your friend on the black part. On the black tip, you gonna have to call your black buddies. You feel me? Nah, you ain't never been like that. I'm not saying do it on the pod, but I'm just saying in life, you always been able to talk to me about anything. So I just want to make sure.
Yeah, we can
talk. Yeah, because people like, damn, he can't talk to his friend about the black issues. How he got a white friend? He can't talk to him about how he feel about.
We can talk about whatever topic you want to talk about.
Look, we can talk about anything, but
we've talked about.
He said, you know, it's some things I don't want to talk about, right?
We've talked about way more uncomfortable topics in general before.
Writer strike. What about it?
Yeah, it's good. I heard that they're finally seem to be a little bit of progress in talks this week.
Really?
Yeah.
What's happening?
Well, for the first time during the strike, this week, the corporations, like the networks, executives, they've finally been open to negotiation and have offered some type of concessions and negotiations. I heard they're still kind of far apart on a couple issues, but
it's not green. Keep talking, Dale.
It's just good that they're both coming to the table, so that's good.
What? They're coming to the table about what?
You got to play. Ending the strike. What's really helped the cause is the actors joining the strike. So it's putting.
You're not saying what happened though. You don't know.
I mean, no.
You don't know what was
what came about with negotiations.
Yeah.
Yeah. So basically, they're being a little cryptic. They're saying that.
Let's say you being cryptic for a second.
Well, you know. Even the WGA, they're saying out of respect for our negotiations, we don't want to entail what is being offered and what we're demanding specifically.
Right.
Because we don't want each layer of this to be dissected by the public. Because
what paper's it?
It's not in the best interest of negotiations.
You gonna do me no good up there.
Which makes sense to me.
Yeah.
You don't want to politicize, make a weapon, something that they're offering you, and then
Yeah, and the public tends to do that anyway. Once it gets out in the public's hands, it's going to go, a snowball effect.
It's best for these negotiations to be private between the two parties, or three parties now, actors and writers alongside each other now. But, just as a somebody, you know, who watches a lot of streaming, like most people, like, I'm just, like, worried and wondering, like, damn, like, how much ripple effects, even if they, like, end the strike now, you know, so many productions are being delayed. But, like, if the delays go, like, into the fall, like, I hear it's going to be, like, devastating. It's going to take, like, forever to catch up.
Can you bring my jar?
So,
I feel like this time right now is another, like, form of a pandemic that, well, it's an epidemic, of course, but it's a pandemic time that I feel like the consumers are kind of not really understand, like, they're under, I feel like we play a role in this.
Absolutely.
And we're getting it off easy, if that's what you're saying.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Like, we're part of the problem, and we're not, nobody has made us stop or boycott anything. Nobody has asked us to do anything. So how do you support,
this is my problem with the masses. We're complacent. Herd mentality. Talk about that all the time. You know what I'm saying?
Talk about consumers' power and how they just don't use it.
Yeah, so that's what gets me. It's like, we the consumers should, like, start cutting subscriptions and being vocal. Like, you know, like, TikToking about that shit.
It's in the top drawer, Jay.
There should be a lot of TikTok influencers, like, try to influence that movement, because, like, at the end of the day...
They ain't gonna do that, though, Dale.
Why not? At the end of the day, like...
Because who's gonna go against...
I can't speak for everybody, but...
Do you know who they're going against?
Me, personally, I'm pretty much out of shows to watch. I'm, like, out.
Do you know who they're going against?
Who?
I'm asking a question.
Oh, they're going against, like, the biggest, like, most powerful, like...
Yeah, so you're asking somebody to just go on TikTok, to just go against the biggest, most powerful thing. You know what I mean? Like, that's not... Bro, nobody's going to do that.
Mass boycotts.
Do you hear me, though? It's mass.
Mass consumer boycotts.
Mass consumer, exactly. But you was talking about a TikTok influencer.
Will absolutely change the person in power more than the people who are striking.
I'm saying you're not hearing what I'm saying. You're missing what I'm saying. I'm not saying it's not possible. I'm saying is a star who is on TikTok going to risk their stardom to stand up to the most powerful thing ever? Like, you don't know people. Do you know somebody that brave? Do you know somebody that brave?
Yeah, absolutely.
But they not.
There's a lot of people on the internet that are reckless. Come on, man.
Yeah, they reckless until the threat of they bag.
So, well, that's
in their life.
That's the question I want to pose and ask. Like,
that's what I'm saying.
So, like, if you're
it's a scary thing to stick your neck out like that.
Against Netflix, you're an influencer, right? Netflix is powerful, but, like, do they have any domain or power within, like, TikTok?
The reality is they don't. But I'm saying through this conversation, we have to convince the creators of that. We're the problem. The influencer you talking about, he has to believe that. She has to believe that in order to actually do the thing that's going to lead the movement. See what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've referenced a couple times. Either way, man.
Say somebody should do something knowing that.
Again, the masses are stupid.
They're not going
to
do it.
It's not too easy. It's not too difficult to do something like.
Stop saying the masses are stupid because the masses are listening.
Okay,
like, don't be rude to the listeners of the podcast, bro. You gotta adjust the conversation. You know,
I am being a little salty about the strike. You know what I'm saying?
Don't, like, take it out on that's, but that's the whole thing. It's like, this is what happens, bro. This is what happens when somebody.
I'm out of shit to watch. I'm a little frustrated.
No, that's not what. That's not, but you always talking. You still talking about the surface. I'm going to the deeper level.
Okay.
The people who caused this problem, just like the people who lied about the Blind Side caused this problem, there's a bunch of people that don't get spoken on that are going through hell because everybody worried about shows.
Oh, I bet.
You see what I'm saying? Everybody worried about shows. You know what I mean? That's what's going to make everybody stand up when they lose their show. But what about the damn kids that you said
Bro, there's a lot.
Got. What about the kids that you said got sent to effed up foster homes over a damn movie that was a lie? That's the deeper level. That's the deeper level. Nobody talking about that. Nobody talking about how, oh, he was alive. Yeah, we can stay on the surface and dance. And da, 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 da. What are we going to do? Sue him, sue him, sue him. Take her Grammys. Take her Grammys. But what you can't repair those kids' lives.
No, not at all. And as smart as you were part of a documentary that wasn't 100% accurate. You know what I'm saying? So
Cap Nation.
You already...
Capitalism.
You know a little better than
capitalism.
Maybe.
It's a capitalism. It's an ism being obsessed with money, bro.
Yeah, you know, capitalism is the ugly side. Capitalism, as far as...
That's what we're going through right now. That's what we're going through.
What do you mean?
The ugly side of capitalism.
Oh, I mean, this is like the ugly side. Yeah, absolutely.
What it is. It's called, what's it called? Dog eat dog. What's it called? Cannibalism. You know what I mean? And it's like, what do we do? Sit by and watch as it happens?
I mean...
Not me. Am I? Oh, I'm a part through it.
Hey, eventually, some fans out there run out of stuff to watch like me might start getting a little ornery. Maybe they might start a movement.
Man, I hate to be this guy, but I'm always this guy. I'm always the guy I hate to be, don't I? I'm one of the main niggas who say, yo, I hate to be that guy, but I'm always that guy. You know what I mean? I don't believe people really ready to get behind something that's good. Because when something is good, nobody's behind it until it's bad.
Yeah.
I don't believe in Americas. Americans, people, I don't believe in humanity. I'ma just say it. Fuck it. I don't believe in none of you niggas. None of you people, none of you bitches, none of you humans, none of you people, whatever you want to be called.
Going to nihilism.
I don't believe none of y'all. Everybody bluffing. I don't believe that if I was to trip up and fall right now, that you would really give a shit. I believe you might give a shit, because you might want to give a shit later, because if you didn't give a shit then in that moment, you know what I mean? Maybe later you might have to pay for not giving a shit in some way, shape, or form. So let me just pay for it up front. I give a shit now.
You already know I'm empath. I don't know what you mean.
Not you, man. Can you pod with me? What talking about you, man? Get out your ego.
Why you shitting on the audience now? You know what I'm saying?
I'm not shitting on the audience.
Why tell them they don't care?
I'm not shitting on the audience, bro. I said I don't believe. Hey, see, he's not gonna talk. He's just listening. You gotta talk, bro.
I'm joking. I'm trying to be serious.
You joking? You can joke. You laughing to me? Make joke.
I just made some jokes.
I'm gonna roast you, Dale.
Like, dang. Like, man, they were empath. Like, you know, man, I'm not on stand up up here, but like, man, I thought they were kind of slightly witty jokes.
What I'm saying? What you hell? Maybe it's just me. That joke flew over my head.
It's called feeding back a line from something that he criticized me for before. You know what I'm saying?
What?
You were saying, like, because I was being a little negative, like, talking, like, shit about, like, public masses in general, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, I remember that, but that's a weak joke, Dale. That's a corny joke. I remember that joke. But anyway, I ain't shitting on your joke. I'm just saying, you know
no,
what I'm
but
saying.
My joke was, like, you was not talking bad about the masses in a sense. That was the joke. All right,
but, yeah, but I am. I don't give a fuck. You know, it's my podcast. It's my damn show. I get to fucking... tell you not to talk shit about the people that I talk shit about.
Well, you gotta moderate.
But at the same time, but I don't believe these niggas, man. I don't. I don't believe nobody no more. Like, everybody be bluffing. And it's not a thing where I say I don't believe everybody be bluffing, like, oh, sad depression. No. It's a thing where it's like, that's life, bro. Life is a impression. Art imitates life? No, life imitates life. Like, everything is an imitation. It's just, what do we say? We living in a simulation? Feel like it's a... everything's a game, bro. And it's sad. But this Michael Orr shit, bro, let me tell you, man. them kids, like I said, that you called the blind side effect. You know, when I Google blind side effect, I can't find what you're talking about. So I got to make a podcast clip to make sure that this is on the internet. Do you see what I'm saying? That's sad.
That's crazy.
That's sad.
That's crazy you're saying that you can't find anything on the internet, because, like, at the time it occurred, like
I didn't say I couldn't find anything. Yeah. I said, what did I didn't find anything when I searched the blind side effect. I'm saying, I'm not saying that it's not nothing out there. I'm saying when I searched that epidemic, it's no log of it happening like how you see everything else on TMZ.
I wonder if it's just like social workers just not talking about the bad side of social workers. You know what I'm saying?
But that's my point. The sad shit. Dale, your mic can pick all that up. I ain't shitting on you, but you can do your thing. But when you do the boom, 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 that shit hit.
What, like new flip-flops?
No, I'm saying when you hit the floor hard or something, you might not be noticing it, but I can hear the boom. Like me moving my foot is like boom, boom, boom.
Got you.
No, you good.
This is something to be mindful of.
It's just, look, I don't care about background noise. I think it brings character, but I don't. Unnecessary background noise.
So mic sensitive. They pick up a lot of background noise. Do you notice? So if I
unnecessary background
noise. A small fart, and I think I got away with it. I probably won't get away with it.
That you ain't getting away with a damn nothing. That's what I be trying to get motherfuckers to get realize. Like, that's why I fuck with you though, because you so chilled. You don't come with bags and wallets and pocket and keys and all this shit. You know what I mean?
I'm just wanting to ask a silly question, but has everybody ever farted on a podcast?
Yeah.
It's called a mic?
Yeah, it's always called a mic. most podcasts, sadly, that are popular or, well, I ain't going to say that. Scratch all that shit I just said. But I had a, like, first... I farted on the fucking podcast first, motherfucker.
We burp on the podcast all the time. I mean,
but I farted on that bitch, and she was like, this is back with the ex. She was like, she made a corny joke. We can't release it.
I'm sorry. I'm just, it's so juvenile.
She's like, we can't release the episode because
it was sometime in the past, like, couple of years. It was it was called on a mic. I think it was like a politician. Maybe it was like a senator or something like that. letting him fart while she was speaking.
Damn.
Maybe it was a reporter talking about something in public. Oh, man, it was funny as shit. It was loud.
Just tell him about it and not pull it up on your phone.
Oh, man. The funny part was, I think it was something like next to them, but like, they definitely heard that joke.
That's fucked up.
And they tried to keep a straight face, so couldn't.
Oh. Yeah, I said all that to say the blind side effect, just all this shit goes under wraps. My producer is like not producing.
Bro.
What you looking at over there? What you got on there?
Hold on.
Nobody's talking about that part of it, though, is what I want to focus.
Do people erase shit off the internet? Because, like,
I'm just going to keep
trying to erase information?
No, I'm not saying it's not there. I'm saying I didn't look.
Okay, I get what you're saying. Not to get
it wasn't there theory. When I searched it, and right. I didn't, you know.
So in 2008,
I'm just saying. Can I finish what I'm saying before you?
Sorry, my bad.
Let me just get this thought out before I fucking lose it.
Oh, go for it.
I just wanted to back up why I feel like everybody's bluffing because of that. You know how many things...
Oh, okay.
How many wounds are made and opened and nobody's around to sew them closed? And everybody talks about they care about this, care about that, but I only see people caring about what the TV talks about.
I feel like, man, nothing's...
Hold up. I only feel people caring about what the TV talk about. If it ain't on YouTube, it don't matter. But it's life going on out here. So now we have gotten to a point. Can you check on the kids? They make a mad noise.
They're playing basketball.
I don't know why they're not in bed. It's 8 o'clock, you know what I mean? It's way past. No, yeah, it's 8 o'clock. No. What was I saying? I don't know.
You were saying how people ain't real and
I'm just saying it's like
it's like hard.
I wish sometimes when I see people rallying that they could just move that energy to another spot, because they don't know that this place that you're putting your energy is pointless. They're just using your energy.
Yeah.
If you was over here, you'd be actually helping somebody.
That's a good point. That's a good point. Because there's so many times, like, we're emotional.
But beings, because it's me doing it on my podcast, people think that I'm trying to get people to feed me. I'm not trying to get you to buy into me and care about me. I'm speaking for a whole bigger thing than me. This is way bigger than me. But don't nobody care. You see what I'm saying? They phony. Because if the ticket price to saving all those kids' lives is listening to Dale and Rondo and actually making the decision to not make a movie like that, if Dale could see it coming, if Dale could see the script of that movie and know what the effect of that movie would have and say, nah, I don't think that you should do this because of this, what's going to happen, and everybody go by that, you could have saved all these lives. If that's the ticket price, I don't think nobody willing to pay the ticket price. That's what I'm saying. It's a bluff. I'm not saying we the way, the truth, and the light. I'm just saying, like, it's problems going on. Okay. And people want to talk about trendy shit. And the trendy shit don't never be a real fucking thing.
Oh, man. So, yeah. Okay, yeah.
It's coming more and more consistently that everything that trends is a fucking hoax.
Yeah, everything. It's never,
because we become fascinated with hoax.
Usually trends are traps too.
Because the world is moving on an algorithm now, Dale. Everybody's on the internet, so everybody's dictating the algorithm. The algorithm has now turned to we care about spoof, prank me. So now we don't know what the fuck is real anymore. And we don't care about what's real because we want to stay in this loop of being duped and unduped and duped. And unduped, and duped, and unduped, and duped, and unduped.
Well, unfortunately, in the last decade, it's been a real... Fake news has been, like, a real thing. And it's like, but, like, fake... But it's like, before somebody out there started popularizing, coining the term fake news, I feel like all news broadcasts were a lot more reputable and a little honorable, had a little more integrity with telling the truth, because there's a lot more flack.
News shouldn't be opinionated.
Yeah.
Once it's opinionated, you should be fired.
Or
simple, no, stop. Because that's not you doing your job. Your job is to deliver the news, period. Boink, 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 doink, doink. Get him out of here. Get him out of here.
Right.
Soon as he start talking about how he feel, run him up out of here. He on the job too long.
I'm with you.
He on the job too long.
Keep it objective.
He on the job too long.
That shouldn't be
how them niggas coming in like a fucking revolving door.
Why can't there be
let the world give you the news? The fucking world. Let everybody in the world.
Why can't there be an objective?
Do you hear what I'm saying? The future of news should be everybody gets to say what's going on. Not one person always dictating. And man, how that shit going like a revolving door? That way the world is telling the fucking news. And we might get some truth up out of here. We might ventilate the earth. All the funky, fake ass shit they got us under this cast. Maybe we might actually can breathe.
Or an organic newscast where somebody's like going to sit events and just getting news from the people.
Why is the answer to all the problems of the world, Ronnie, why don't you create it?
Not for reporters or cops.
Why is all the answers to the problem of the world? Why don't you make it? But I'm saying, though, why? But that's my point. That's my point.
Okay.
What needs to happen hasn't happened yet.
True.
So I don't want to hear nobody talking about nothing no more until they do what need to happen.
And so people need to start. People need to act more.
Act, man. I'm about acting, bro. Like, fuck the words, man.
Too many talkers.
Words is deceptive. Niggas is using words to not have to do shit.
And too many people spend too much time online talking shit about something rather than taking action.
Here we go. We ain't taking no damn ass.
Talking shit online.
What we doing, Dale? What we doing? That's the next question. What we doing about it?
Opening up some kind of forum, possibly.
Mm. I mean, that's all we do. That's all we can do. I mean, I'm not.
You do have to, before you interact with fans.
I was gonna say this is the deeper layer, though. Everybody's not built in this fight or this thing that we talking about. I don't even want to look at it as a fight because I don't look at it as that. I just look at it as my life purpose because I am the bubble in the fucking, you know, what's it called, the IV. You know what I mean? I'm that air bubble.
That's not a good analogy.
No, I'm that air bubble.
You gonna kill somebody? a bubble in the IV.
The somebody is the worst thing everybody on earth hates. When I was born, I come through. I'm that air bubble, and now it's dead because I was born.
That's kind of dark, but okay, I got you.
So you want this monster of social work and this beast of entertainment and all of this shit that collided and destroys these kids' lives to kind of continue, my nigga?
No, I don't want that.
Okay, I'm just the air bubble destroying that shit. Oh. Why can't nobody think positively?
Oh, okay. I missed your analogy, man. My bad.
Positively. Think positively. It's sad. We got to think positively.
It's just kind of a dark
because analogy. Everybody think they breathing right now when we not. We not breathing right now. You're not alive. This shit ain't living. We got to get from under them. If we get from under that and get ahead of it and start dictating something and building something,
I'm with you. There's too much complacency.
Then you can breathe.
Complacency is just, man, abound. Complacency is like one of the worst enemies.
I just don't want to hear nobody until they're ready to do what needs to be done because, oh yeah, this is what I was going to say. Everybody isn't the same, so everybody doesn't have to do has the same job. Like, you don't have to do what I do, Dale, to do your part. You know what I mean?
Well, I'm glad for that, because I don't know the first thing about doing what you do.
You know what I mean? That, you don't have to do Black Lives Matter rallies. You know what I mean? You don't have to do that. Look, he's happy. I got him off the hook for that. Look, you don't have to do that. You know what I mean? You don't have to march. You know what I mean? You don't have to... Everybody's not supposed to do everything. You know what I mean? Man. That's what people don't realize, too, with this movement. Man, tools and pieces in place. People are tools and pieces.
My bad principle for saying, like, when Black Lives Matter, like, in Tacoma Park, you know what I'm saying? When I was, like, when it was a new movement, there was a bunch of white folks in the corner of Wayne Avenue, a Dale Drive by Silver Spring. It sounds like out there all day. Black Lives Matter, I'm just thinking to myself, like, man, like, that's great, y'all supporting, man, they were, like, really passionate out there. Mm-hmm. It's like, what are y'all really doing, though, man? Like, is there something else you can be doing? like, there's probably, like, council meetings at the Civic Center.
Let me tell you something about the coolest white people ever. Decisions. The coolest white people ever, Dale. The coolest white people ever ain't doing that shit, bro.
Yeah, like, but they were out there, like, all day. And I'm just driving by him a few times, like...
Yeah, I don't want no Becky in them.
Yeah.
Sandra and Sandra,
like,
Bullock.
It was like some white couples out there with their kids. And they was, man, like, just waving at cars. All cars are honking.
Black Lives Mattering. They was doing it.
They had that corny sign up. Honk if you support this.
Hey, you want to know something? I recorded a song, right? You remember that song I recorded? I did a freestyle. I was walking down the street, right? And I was like, yo, this white bitch honked at me. And she, like, think we cool because Black Lives Matter going on right now. Like, she think...
Well, she honked at you?
She like, I'm supporting. And I'm like, hold up. Everything ain't cool just because you fucking... Because Black Lives Matter is a thing right now.
Who wants to get honked at? Like, man.
She's like, I support. Bitch, support? Bitch, I'm just walking. You support niggas walking down the street?
Man,
hey, I'm with that.
Hey, yo,
what if a nigga could get like a bunch of white girls to just cheer for him for everything he do every day? Is that where we coming to?
If I'm walking into Sahasa, Dave, you want to give me a nice cold bottle of water?
Hey, yo, hey, yo.
Stop and give me a bottle of water.
As soon as I wake up, just for being black, hey, yo, clap for me, man. Like, what are we asking for here, bro? That's crazy. I ain't asked for that. I'm just walking. I'm like, shorty, really think we got something in common? Like, we got something going on. Nah, I don't even know you. You ain't helping me. You thinking that my life matter don't help me.
Man, that last few years has been just fucking crazy.
It's insane what we've accepted. But it's not, because I was born only 26 years ago, and I understand this world pretty well. It does this. We do this. We tend to do this shit. You know what I mean?
But no.
And it's just, if you think about what year it is, it makes sense that it evolved to this.
What you're saying is right.
We just evolved to this.
It's evolved rapidly to a point where what you said, like, it's crazy that we fucking accept this.
Yeah.
And it's like, damn, like 10 years ago,
we would have never took this shit.
Never.
We would have never took this shit.
There's so much extreme shit going on every day. It's like crazy.
And I knew something about COVID. COVID bust us open. COVID popped our cherry too. It did. Because it made us feel like
it exposed
no virgins no more. Like, we done been through, we done seen the other side. We think we ain't seen shit.
Well, do you know what COVID really, really did? Honestly, so
it's a hoax, right?
It's not a hoax. But anyway,
we got him.
Anyway, what it really did was
make him paranoid. He feel paranoid already because I keep looking at you.
Who had like some under the cover, they were just maybe hiding or managing some mental health issues going on. I'm saying this in a sensitive way.
Papers,
not
man.
Not a judge, keep no way, but when COVID went on,
doing
like,
that.
When hospitals were shut down, and like nobody could get a doctor appointment for anything, like people who were having like
people was having funerals on Zoom.
But like if you were having a mental health crisis or issue, like you could not get an appointment with like a therapist.
That's crazy. Like, yeah.
Initially, it was so crazy.
See, but that was the other thing. So
I feel like a lot of mental health situations exploded.
See, before the pandemic, I was doing certain things in my life. And I remember people calling me crazy. And then I remember the pandemic happened, and then BetterHelp came out.
What do you mean?
I remember doing things before the pandemic.
I heard what you said, but what do you mean?
I remember doing things before the pandemic.
Okay.
And then after the pandemic, during, BetterHelp came out.
Okay, yeah.
They were prepared. I don't think that that's cap. You might think that that's cap. That might be a conspiracy to somebody. But I'm not stupid. I've been on the earth for 26 years, bro. I'm not dumb. I know the games. I know the games we play. I know the games we play. Hey, poo, go in the house. Hey, poo, hey. Get your ass in the house. Fuck that, damn it. Get in the house. Hey, get in the house. Hey, I know you sad. Hey, depressed. Hey, I'm still talking to you. Motherfucker, open your phone. That's all you got, right? Hey, open your phone. Here. Talk to this motherfucker. Hey, I'll help you. I got you. I'll help you.
So,
this is how we do things now. Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is 2023. My name is Earth, bitch.
You know what?
My name is Life.
2023 is a
coming
lot,
at you.
A lot better than 2020.
Listen to the track, bitch.
Man.
What do you think about that?
What do I think about what?
DoorDash, Zoom, BetterHelp, stocking tissue, stocking and hand sanitizer, and it's not a hoax. It's not a fucking hoax.
I might be judged for this comment.
Not saying it's not.
I never used DoorDash.
That nobody died, that not nobody got sick. I'm not saying none of that. Just saying.
Let's go back to the 90s.
The rest of it, they ain't got nothing to do with that.
All right, so let's go back to the 90s.
And the world don't need to change around a flu, a cough, a cold, or somebody dying. Because people died every day before, what you said, 10 years ago, and we ain't changed the world. People died from the flu a lot, and nobody changed the world over it.
So I just want to talk about food delivery service really quick in a joke, because that's something that's like really changed.
Takeout taxi.
And takeout taxi was like the original. Like,
yeah, you know, OG, y'all don't know about that.
Before, like, the internet and shit. So, like, that was an option, but, like, I remember, like, there were times, like, you'd be a group of friends and you'd be fucked up or whatever, like, oh, man, we'll do a takeout taxi. But, like, it was always, like, a big decision because that shit was expensive. It'd be, yeah, like, a $25 delivery fee or some shit. Like, no bullshit. So it was always, like, it was rarely used. It was not a go-to thing. Motherfuckers did that shit, like, but rarely.
Yeah.
So now you have all these services, but, like, how much do you have to pay as a consumer to, like, use
they would tax you.
Or Uber?
Tax.
Uber
Eats? Tax.
Tax?
Tax. Tax them. Tax them. Tax them. Tax them. Tax them.
So if it
it's like a strip club. They just add a charge.
How much is a charge if McDonald's is 10 minutes from here, all right? McDonald's 10 minutes from here. What's going to charge, like, the extra? I'm getting a Big Mac meal that costs McDonald's $9. How much extra am I paying for that shit? Not tip included.
Wait, wait, you tell me. What,
you tell you me $5? So it'd be like, okay, so not tip included.
So right. You tell me. That light is a switch.
So I guess that sounds about like what it would cost for like a one-way ride for like an Uber or Lyft anyway, right? So if I'm taking an Uber or Lyft one way there, that'd probably be what it'd be, like $5.
You asking me? I don't know.
Yeah, so it sounds like somebody in the background.
So okay, now next, move on.
Okay, so it's reasonable. Like we're going from like $5. That like when it was takeout taxi, that would have been like
$25. Why are you talking about this?
It's just.
What is the point of that?
The whole point of this is how did it become so cheap?
Because
with the advent of the internet and technology.
No, like, it's the pandemic. They got rich. They banked on us, bro. I'm trying to tell you.
Huh, okay.
Where do you think they got the money from? They just invented the shit. I was working for them. I was sitting there, Dale, and I said, I could have thought about this shit if I knew this shit was coming. No. Hold up. Let me talk.
Go ahead.
I could have thought about this. I could have invented DoorDash if I knew a pandemic was coming. I would have made DoorDash. Because people was delivering shit before. I remember I had somebody put a pizza on the floor, on the ground outside my door before. I said, bro, where they do that at? And that was before the pandemic. What's way me? Before the pandemic. Let me talk. I'm what? Talking. I'm going to tell you whatever you probably asking. I've seen a motherfucker do it. Put the motherfucker down on the... And I say, hold up. Is this the evolution? You know what I mean? are we getting to the point where he's so antisocial or he on his phone that he don't want to even talk to me? He don't want to deal with nothing. He ain't even telling me the shit was there. I opened the door, the pizza there. God damn, nigga, you ain't gonna tell me the pizza there?
I guess he didn't want
to. You ain't got no doorbell, nigga. Fuck it. I'm out.
I guess he didn't want to.
It was digital. Following. You ain't following the game. He already got his tip. He don't gotta do nothing.
Gotcha.
It's all incorporated. That's why you tip later, after you eat and actually feel satisfied. Then you tip. But then they call you cheap. But anyway, what's happening is society's colliding on itself and it has no idea that it's happening. It's the people who are real ass bitch give a fuck about a nigga, you know what I mean? And then it's reality. People living in the real world. And that is clashing right now because of that pandemic. They met worlds because everybody had to sit down and stop. Everybody was in the same position. And I prophesized on this podcast even, and my ex, she would never attest to this, but, you know, she was there when I said something's going to happen to where everybody's going to feel how I feel. Everybody's going to be in the same position at one time. And it's not just about me, but I'm saying...
The great equalizer.
No, it's not about me. I'm saying everybody's going to
Something's going to happen where everybody's going to be in the same position.
Boat. Same boat, huh?
Same boat, and we're going to realize who our real enemy is. Huh. And it's not us. It's...
We're going to see everybody
so in the same what, boat. What's happening now, people are coughing up COVID. COVID is bigger than a sickness and a virus.
It exposed a lot of other things.
COVID is not just a virus. It was a bigger thing than that. It was a social adjustment.
Social adjustment.
A societal adjustment. An alteration of our country.
We still have drastic societal.
We changed the world.
Bro, over certain things like movie theaters. Nobody goes to movie theaters anymore.
Yeah.
And that used to be
my such bad. A big, I ain't let him talk.
No, you good.
Talk, please.
I need you to talk. Like movie theaters. Like that used to be such a big thing. Like nobody's going to movie theaters anymore. There's certain industries that like changed from the pandemic that it's like, are they going to change back? Like working from home. So many major companies have struggled with workers fighting that shit. Like, man, fuck that shit. But it's like, yo, don't be entitled, man. You got to work from home. Like, I'm sorry, I wasn't excited because, like, you know, I was in that situation to work from home. And I still not, but I don't know. Me personally, like, I enjoy going to a different workplace environment than my home. You know what I'm saying? So like,
you know, nobody, it's not human to work where you sleep. It's not human.
Yeah.
Unless you're an artist, it's not human.
Now, if you got kids, working from home is a beautiful thing. That's, you know, but
when I say it's not human, I'm saying the job you'll be doing wouldn't be a job that a human you see what I'm saying? It would still have to be a human on site somewhere.
This is where
we're doing something.
This is where working from home
for you to work at home. Yeah, and this you see what I'm saying?
People who work from home, they need to be careful with the ages we're living in with like AI. It's like don't force like your boss to innovate their companies. Like, you know what? Maybe we'll just put some robots.
Robots
coming to our office.
Don't say don't force them, though. It's happening. This is what I'm telling you. It's happening. And nobody knows that society is a aluminum foil wrap right now being crumbled inward. Like, just folded in on itself.
Imploding in certain ways. Yeah.
And nobody's noticing it.
Yeah.
So, Rondo Show Podcast episode 35. Yeah. That's crazy.
Man, alright. So one thing that changed dramatically with the pandemic is like tipping, right? It's so fucking whack. And it's like, I'm great, like people are now like been starting to talk about like last year or two. Like it was something I noticed off the break and a problem for me. Where you go to like regular fucking stores and ask for tips. Going like Five Below. You wanna like tip? Like, what the fuck?
Right.
Who
am I
tipping $1 for what?
Right.
So
let me tell you something. Everybody went in a scam bag. I watched it happen because I was actually homeless during the pandemic. So I was outside during the pandemic. I saw everything change.
Like scam bag, like what do you mean?
I was outside every day.
What kind of things did you see?
I watched everybody, every human that I saw, went into their scam bag.
Oh, started like changing their mode.
Everybody went into their scam
bag. They're like, okay. It's that time right now.
It's time to look out for self.
Things are a little...
Let's look out for me.
Yeah, we're in scary times. Things are lawless.
A little bit
Wild Wild West, huh?
Shit shifted. It's weird getting your order taken in the middle of a pandemic. Because they like... Do I gotta be right here right now? I guess I'll press this. Okay, what you want?
But do people...
You know what I mean? It's like, what you want? You want a Big Mac? I got bigger fish to fry. No pun intended.
So with the tipping thing, right? So people like are starting to know it now, but like it's so like shady how like majority of times like you might tip some, it's not going to that person serving you anyway. It's going to the damn corporation. So it's these corporations trying to absorb losses in certain inflation.
Exactly, and they're getting their money back that they lost on this fucking pandemic. This is how,
like, companies try to, like, get back losses from the pandemic and, like, try to battle inflation.
And they did all of this.
Do you want to tip?
They just robbed us, and y'all just sat at home and let them do it. That's just what happened.
Oh, there's still savvy people with savvy to it now, but, like...
Ain't nobody talk about this shit, bro.
But then again, there are some also blind sheep that also are part of the problem. That will like tip something like mindlessly.
Do you hear what I'm saying? The government robbed us. America's told us to sit home on and get robbed, and they're coming for more money after. That's crazy.
We got them stimulus checks.
They ain't give us, bro. Don't you do that. That's a funny joke, ice,
bro.
What?
You got one, right? You didn't get one? Everybody got one, bro. Like the that $1,600 one, or $1,200 one, or whatever one. The one that Donald Trump had to sign.
Don't yell on the pod. First off,
my bad.
Second of all,
you didn't get one personally signed check from. Let me tell you, man.
Hey, chill. I know you promoting Budweiser right now. You know, you could turn the label to help your brother out. You know what I mean?
My bad. You know, big shout out. You know, Washington Commanders. They're thriving again. There's still a deal back with them. Okay. My bad. If I turn it this way, no, man, I can drink.
You can turn it back to drink.
I'm joking. Go ahead, man.
Yo, I'm saying the stimulus is nothing. Not even, like, Jay, you know a drop in the bucket is more than a stimulus, right?
What's a drop in the bucket?
Hold on. Don't talk. You know a drop in the bucket is more than a stimulus, right? Yeah? Yeah. You know that, right? So, let me tell you something about player moves. They funding this Ukraine shit, right? Where do you think they got all that money from?
I have no clue.
The pandemic. We robbed the Americans. We told them stay home, wear a mask, put your girls' panties on your face.
How did they make money off that?
Put your girls' panties on your face.
How did they make money off that?
And you talking about they gave you $1,000, so you happy? Yo, they got trillions off your ass. Like, they got trillions up out of us.
Jeff Bezos did.
Taxes.
Jeff Bezos did.
Everybody did.
Hey.
You know he has to pay taxes, right?
Well, okay, I get that. But Jeff Bezos profited more than anybody during the pandemic.
Everybody profited, Jeff. Don't sleep. Don't Jeff be sleep. Bezos profited. I was outside. I saw people make money.
I hear you.
I saw everybody.
I hear you. But if you think somebody released COVID, it might have been Jeff Bezos, because that motherfucker made like $800 trillion.
Why are you telling me that I think somebody released COVID? Don't put narratives on me.
I thought you said something about we did this, we let COVID happen, so this could ABC could happen.
I said we let them tell us that we couldn't go to work. I remember how angry people were when they say, "Nope, can't go to work," and that anger just went away. What happened to that? Whatever happened to, there's you can't
people,
tell man, me not.
Some people not feeling it.
That's my point, but what's happening? You know what I'm saying. You already get it. I ain't even got to argue with you. It's not even an argument.
Got you.
You get what I'm saying?
I do.
Do you?
I believe so.
I need you to talk then. Give me something. Give me something. I'm going to listen, and I'm going to see if we're on the same page.
So you're saying there's different ways in which...
I'm not asking you to tell me what I'm saying. I'm asking you to respond to what I'm saying from your perspective. And I'm trying to gather from what you say
in general,
if you understand what I'm saying.
In general, COVID changed a lot of different things. And we let these things happen in certain different ways.
Yeah. And it didn't have to go this way. Everybody, they took advantage of opportunity to rob us, and they robbed us. They dug their hand in the bag, too. It's like, and you, me, and Dupree let it slide.
We can all be blind sometimes. So it's, you know,
I don't think it's blind, bro. It was a tiredness, bro. I think people are tired of this. Yeah. So they don't care anymore. That's why I be saying, yeah, I think people are bluffing, bro.
They're not built for this.
Yeah. I'm built for it, bro. I'm going to beat the game, bro. I'm built for it. I'm not going down.
Folks,
I'm
just too tired to be vigilant, huh?
Man, they ain't going to get me, bro. I'm a salamander, but I got infinite water sources.
So you feel me?
I'm a salamander, but I got infinite water sources. You think my back going to dry out? Nah, my nigga. Nah, Jay gonna spray me with that water bottle.
You lose something to grow back, huh? You got that Wolverine, that Deadpool.
Stay alive, young black man.
That Deadpool power.
Stay alive, young black man.
That's crazy. That is cool, like, how animals can, like, regrow a fucking limb. So some animals have, like, superhero properties. That's some crazy shit.
Let's name three, and then we gonna do pie picks, and let's get up out of here.
What, name three animals that can do that shit?
Yeah, and we'll talk about it, and then we do pie picks, and then we'll end it.
Salamander, we already said one.
No, that's not on the tape. That's not an option. Man, don't try to bite my shit.
Earthworm.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You cut a worm in half, it'll form two separate worms.
Nice. Okay. Okay. Another one.
Another one. There's not too many animals that I can just think off the top of my head that do that shit.
Yes, it is. Come on, man. A skink.
A skink?
Yes. If their tail.
Well, a skink is a salamander, man. It's in the salamander family.
Okay, I guess.
Same type of skin and everything.
So now what? So how many other? Others are there. I know insects definitely do it.
Spiders, bro. There's definitely tons of spiders.
Yeah, yeah.
And also, there's crabs.
Anything else? Fish?
Probably fish. Like tentacles or something. A whisker or something like that. Like, crabs and octopuses, I'm sure.
You know, Octopi.
Well, one thing is, a fascinating question to think about, though. Because octopuses are...
So I love this tree stump. I got ash on it.
got a good service for that, huh?
Yeah.
But anyway, octopuses are the only animals we know in the world that have 9 brains.
Wow.
I don't know what we were talking about, but like they have one central brain, but they each...
So while he fucking, he can be thinking about cooking breakfast.
We just don't understand octopuses. But no. Each one of their arms has their own brain.
He could be thinking about cooking breakfast, whipping an omelet.
No, so each one of their arms.
Oh, that's why Pixar does that.
Technically,
that's why Pixar takes
do something completely independent of them central brain.
They took that phenomena, that reality of life, and put it in Final Draft.
So it's like
you know what I mean? It just
a fish went by, burning against a tentacle. Like the central brain doesn't like pick up on that. Like there's another brain that picks up on that.
That's crazy.
But it's fascinating to think about.
And it grows its tentacles back.
It can grow a tentacle against multiple. But I'm wondering like where the brain is located in the arm, and if it can grow a brain back, that would be.
If it can produce brains, that's wild. Like if it could on the spot on command, if it needed to. Replace his brain, transplant his own brain. You know,
I don't see why it would be totally out of the question if it could regenerate.
What you need?
Oh, so I don't know if I can search that fart.
Bring the whole bag over. No, just take the beer up. Yeah. Take the other beer up for me.
Gotcha, bro. Yeah.
Appreciate it.
No problem.
Are you struggling?
I'll take that one. Thank you. Nobody's got to take the one that I dropped. All right. So anyway, DHA.
And the cup was for you too. So if you pour the beer in the cup too, it helps with the not promoting
I'll
of.
Just, I'll just be mindful of the label.
Okay.
But omega-3 DHA can I believe, replenish brain tissue.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. Ah, shit.
That's why it's such a selling point.
High in omega-3s.
Oh, yeah. It's the only substance we know that can...
This podcast is high in omega-3s.
It's the only thing that we know.
This podcast is high in omega-3s?
It's the only thing that we know that can,
this podcast is
that can repair our brain.
Do you think this podcast is an omega-3?
Could be seeing somebody's consciousness. Helping them grow.
You know, that's my goal, is to be able to have a show that I've created that if you were, like, damn near about to be gone, it would bring you back.
Revival.
Just listening to this shit would just bring you back.
So you're
you'll be able to live through this shit.
You're a revivalist.
Yeah.
I dig it.
Is that crazy?
Nah, that's a beautiful vision. It's not crazy.
You paused. I just want to note that.
I just didn't want to spill any beer myself.
You know something, Dale?
What's up?
We on episode 135. This airs Saturday next week. The week after.
Okay. Actually.
And, well, yeah, next Saturday. And, you know, people are on, like, episode 2,000, 300, 400, 600, 700, 800. And they don't want to talk about this shit at all, man.
Talk about horseshit.
What we just went to.
Okay, so you talking about something else? Like, I thought we talking about
this. I love this guy. Yo, you're a star, bro. I love you. Wonder why?
Why is that?
Because you don't even know why that's a thing.
Why? What's the thing?
Exactly. Rondo Show Podcast, episode 135. I appreciate you. Yo, Dale, Pop Picks, what you got?
Oh, man, I got some bangers.
Oh, shit. Connect to the speaker, please, Dale. Please do this for me this time. Please love my
heart. Oh, okay.
For 1 second.
Oh, do a little upgrade.
You always freaking playing it out your phone, crushing my ears when I'm trying to edit. It's a Fox. FOX is what you'll see. Are you connected?
Not yet. Okay. I got.
Don't. No. Connect, please. Connect first.
I'm not going to connect because I got quite a few. I need a second, bro.
Dale, I'm telling you to connect so that way when you play whatever you play, it's not going to be through your phone. I don't want to hear you.
I was going to try to get like
through your phone.
If I wasn't sure about the song,
I was in my ears. It's going to kill me, bro.
On low.
No, it's not like that. You got a mic on your chest. What are you talking about?
Bluetooth? What am I connecting to?
Come on, man. I told you Fox, man. All you got to look at for is Fox, man.
Oh, shit. I'm on the Fox Network? Okay. With Tucker Carlson.
You Tucker Carlson.
You
the angel and he the devil.
I guess I walked into that, huh?
Are you connected?
Yeah, I'm connected. I believe so.
Okay.
Man.
He's so mad he connected. That nigga did not want to connect. See? So, that's the problem with whites and blacks right now. They don't want to connect with each other.
I talk about the station all the time. I'm not going to shout out specifically. But there's so much random shit, man.
Unplug that. You can close the door and stuff. Just unplug that. Put that inside. Close the door. Talk, Dale. Would you say?
Just like so many random genres. So some of these genres of like songs, like I don't even know how to describe them. All right, this is a really good song.
You have to describe it before you play it. You have to say the title, name, talk about. You don't have to do all that.
Roman Holiday. The group is Fontaines DC. This is a
deep cut.
This is an alternative song. I'm gonna go to YouTube so I can get the actual full song here. Ah, shit.
If you really lit, you gonna make sure that ad don't play on this shit. If you gonna let me DJ you.
Sorry, I don't have the premium YouTube, I don't believe. Oh, no ads. She's got a really chill vibe.
Yeah, I appreciate it, girl.
Yeah, I got a guitar riff too.
Back.
Yeah, like kind of like a beach, like a beach, like a beach weather vibe. Listen to that guitar. Listen to that guitar, bro. Come on, get inside. That's different. That's good, right?
Oh.
Right? She's got a good, clean sound.
You won't pay for it, right?
What's that?
You won't pay for it, right?
You won't pay for what? Absolutely. You don't have to worry about what it costs. You know, it's the update where it's new.
Just don't make sure don't know next another song play like last pod.
Another song like what?
Remember last pod when that other song came on?
Nah, I don't. What song was that?
Some random songs just played while you was playing your podcast.
Okay, that's because I was like listening to samples on Shazam. This is the YouTube full version. No interruptions. This is a good song just to like mellow out to, you know? Maybe for like a road trip. It's a good road trip song.
It's a good song right now, bro. Yeah. See our cat friend?
What's that?
It's a mama cat. See our cat friend?
Oh, nice. That's a pretty cat, man.
Birth so many kittens around here, bro.
She was a soldier,
like,
man.
She on her like fifth litter.
Yeah, that's a little soldier, man.
She gotta have more than five. We witnessed it, five. I swear.
That's a survivor right there.
Yeah.
That's pretty good, right?
Yeah.
You want to pause it?
No, you good. Play all three. All right. Play your next one. What's the next part?
That's better work. All right. Here we go.
Cause now I got now you got competition.
One more. Here
the competition. Thank you, Jay. Thank you for producing this
podcast. Oh, she produced her first podcast, y'all.
She produced her first episode. You did so well, and we didn't even use the trending topic. Your energy and your space was just enough.
Come on, Dale. What's come on with the pie, man? You can't just sit on the air, dead air.
Oh man,
come on, worst DJ ever.
There was
so many good ones I had last night.
We in hour six, hour two, 16 minutes in, and he wanted to have dead air.
Nah, there were so many good ones I have. Like, I really want to play like that one I had. I said it was like, yo, this is it.
That's what she said. Can you get something for the baby cat? Please.
Thank you for bearing with me.
Hey.
Huh?
That's it. That's it.
Hey,
baby. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna go with this one. I don't think there's a song that I really want to, but this is a really good one.
Close the door. You can listen, you know. Right there.
So this song came out.
You don't gotta stand right here. The internet gonna be like, yo, you made her stand right there.
Yeah, you ain't gonna give me no scissors to cut this with?
Stay right here. Come on. You still with us. You still on the episode. Come on. I need scissors to cut this. But I'm saying, you, where was you going? You was just getting a tablet?
Okay. No, actually, this song is a little older than that.
Come on, Dale, play the song, man. You take it forever, man.
All right. Here we go.
This nigga, man.
Y'all motherfuckers on the pod over here. Y'all go crazy. You don't know where the scissors are?
Stop.
In the house. You alright? I know pod is lit, bro. So I tell you, it's lit, bro. It's lit.
Good for this shit.
You can be built for body too if you want to.
Not like me.
The tracks I found in this song, man, they're just too low, man. I'll just go with my next pick.
Damn, can you just. Yo, I'm about to lose my mind, yo.
I'm sorry, man.
Damn. Yo, I didn't know this was going to be this hard. Swear to God,
it's not.
It's just going to be the smoothest thing ever.
There we go.
And he can't do it. And it's an ass still got to play on my podcast, yo. Never fails. He can't skip it. He can't mute the thing when it's on an ad. He can't turn the volume down and just DJ it right.
Here we go. This one's called Pierce the Veil.
Dale, are you listening to me, bro?
I am.
You're not listening to me. Let me tell you something. When you playing the ad, turn the volume down.
I hear your feedback.
You know what I mean? Turn the volume down on the shit. That's all I'm saying.
I'll keep that in mind for the future. Yes, huh?
You, no, you good. You could have been gone. Why are you stuck?
Are you being sarcastic?
I said you could have been right there. That's why the screen is down. That's what I was trying to tell you earlier. You was like, I'm making room too. I'm sorry. Now it's my turn, huh?
I believe so.
You disconnected yet?
I did.
I ain't even prepared to do all this shit talking about Dale. I ain't even fucking prepared. Like, I want to get...
Or is it okay if I disconnect that? The smoke's blowing in my face.
Yeah.
I'm just going to stay on this side. That's okay.
Well, you good.
Yeah,
that's the whole point of Power Pitch. It's like you get to get up and relax, stretch. You know what I mean? Get your fucking the music. What? Let the music
they
play.
Can still, they can still hear me, right?
Yeah.
All
right. I'm mic'd up. So, but you see what I'm saying, right?
Yeah.
This is how the flow should be. Like, it's certain things we can implement to keep the flow good for, and keep everybody comfortable.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? So I'm not forcing. I don't force nothing on nobody. I want people to organically grow and learn into how much they want to. If you don't want to go deeper, don't go deeper. If you want to go deeper, go deeper. Like you said, all this editing, like muting the ads and all that shit. You ain't got to mute the ads if you can't mute the ads. I'll do it for you. Or but give me the pod
pick. In general, if I be mindful, it'll help save you time.
If you feel like doing that.
I don't mind helping you save time.
Yeah, okay. Sometimes you be like, yo, I told Jay, I was like, hey, this man saw myself. Yo, can you edit this out? We can edit this out, right? I'm like, bruh. Yeah, we can, but I really don't feel like being up to edit that out. You know what I mean? Let's just try to get it right on the
first take.
Let's know what we're doing before we do it, so that way it's done once it's done.
It could be, or it could be a little more seamless.
And it could be so organic.
And seamless.
It's seamless. And it's always been seamless, Dale. It has always been seamless because that's what I do. I fucking commit to that shit. I commit to making it seamless, my nigga.
That's your first rodeo, bro.
My first fucking rodeo. And I really love you. That's the other thing. We really fucking friends. So it's so easy to talk to you that I don't need to push. I don't need to push on you or
push the script.
Yeah, yeah. I don't need to. I don't need to do all. I don't want to do what they do. I don't do what they do. I'm not them.
So what are your pot picks, bro? You got me. I'm anticipating.
You wonder what my pie paste is? Just because Ice Cube is in the news right now. What you think about Ice Cube, Dale?
What's Ice Cube in the news for?
He been doing the podcast tour, bro. He been going to every show.
Huh.
Talking about...
What's he talking about?
You know, politics and shit. But I ain't gonna get too into it. I'm gonna just play some old Ice Cube.
Man... You know, Ice Cube, I've always been pretty much a fan of him for the most part. But, man, I don't know what he was doing. Like, that one year, like, last election, he, like, gave Trump a somewhat endorsement. Like, I don't know what that shit was about.
That's what he doing. That's
he's endorsing Trump again?
I ain't saying he endorsing Trump.
He's and unintentionally giving him some love and some publicity?
I'm not saying that's what he's doing.
That's what he did last time, unintentionally.
I'm not saying that's what he's doing. Dale, you gotta also know when I'm potting, don't be putting me on no ledge and you off the camera, nigga. Don't be doing that. That's fucked up.
Bro, I'm sorry, man.
Don't do that to me. Let me get the song down before you fucking avoid singing smoke. You know what I mean? You hear what I'm saying, though. Don't try to hit me with the ledge question.
Wait till I come back to
yeah, sit with me and go through this hell. All right, so I'm gonna play Ice Cube 1991, and then I'm gonna play Ice Cube 2006. Those are my two pod picks. I'm gonna go with Oh, my shit just disconnected. Turn it back on, Dale. Yep. Turn the power. You find the power button? Got it? I will. Damn, I'm a Bluetooth.
I'm a battery's good.
Yeah, hold it. I'm gonna go with True to the Game. I might play three songs. Let's see.
Bro, you are on that filter.
Yeah, it's done. I'm trying to figure out why it's not playing. Bro, it's good. It's don't flashing. Touch it. Don't touch it.
Yeah, you that motherfucker that betrayed your homeboys and you ain't. Yeah. Yeah, you about to get your motherfucking ghetto pass. Fuck, motherfucker. Fuck ass, smart, bitch, man. It's the nigga, you love to hate with a new song. So what will it go?
Okay.
Nothing but a come.
What's the name of this?
But ain't that
true to the game.
They hate to see a young nigga rich.
They see a young nigga rich.
Switch, nice. Even though. Cause I can't move to the snow. As soon as y'all get some dough, you wanna put a white bitch on your elbow. Moving out your neighborhood, but I walk through the ghetto, and the flavor's good. Little kids jumping on me, but you wanna be white and corny. Living way out, nigga, go home. Spray paint is on your house. Trying to be white or a Jew, but ask yourself, who are they to be equal to? Get the hell out. Stop being a Uncle Tom, your little sellout. House nigga scum. Give something back to the place where you made it from before you end up broke. Fuck around and get your ghetto pass revoked. I ain't saying no names. You know who you are, you little punk. Be true to the game.
You hear that?
I'm helping you.
Remember when you said, what's the thing, he a sellout for what he did with Trump?
When you first start rhyming, it started off
a sellout.
I'm asking.
And then you started
I don't understand his intention.
But it wasn't
intention.
Fast enough, yeah. I guess.
That's all.
So you get
I just don't want to buy
it. You're not calling a sellout. I said, I don't
know. Go ahead. Just let it play.
Our music away to the mainstream. Don't you know they ain't down with the team? They just said they boss over. Put a bug in your ear. And now you're crossover on MTV, but they don't care. They'll have a new nigga next year. You're out in the cold. No more white fans and no more
soul. Damn.
And you might have a heart attack when you find out the black folks don't want your back.
Damn.
And you know what's worse? You was just like
Jay.
The nigga in the first
place. Need something to drink.
Stop selling out your brakes and wipe that stupid ass smile off your face. Niggas always gotta show they teeth. Now I'ma be brief, be true to the game.
Yeah, motherfucker, I see you got your fans and cars and shit. But you know what? You still ain't shit. That's right.
I'm gonna get rid of
you. Know I forgot you. Yeah, but I didn't even quit.
A message to the Oreo cookies. Find a mirror. And take a look, G. Do you like what you see?
Take a cup back.
Finger at me. You want to be a fish. You little guppy.
Oh, appreciate the
look
out, man.
Black man can't be no yuppy. You put on your suit and tie.
I came over.
You heard me.
I came over. At 0 o'clock.
You want to be like that. It's calling you a nigga behind your back.
It was for before.
So back off, genius. I don't need you to correct my broken knee. You know that. Right? You ain't white. So stop holding your ass tight. Cause you can't pass. So why you keep trying to pass with your black ass? Mr. B. But in reality, you're shorter than a man.
You only got yourself to blame. Get a grip, Oreo, and be true to the...
So you get that. That's pretty simple.
Okay.
I'm gonna go with Laugh Now, Cry Later. Uh-huh. 2006, Ice Cube.
I don't give a fuck about what y'all talking about. I ain't trying to hear none of that shit. Nigga, I'ma do what I wanna do, when I wanna do it, how I wanna do it. And you better hope I don't do it to you. Now, I don't care what mama got to say. I don't care what grandmama got to say. Nigga, I'm grown. Let me tell you a little something about me. I was born not to give a fuck. Wanna drink, get your cup. Turn it up, throw it up. Blow it up, somebody slow it up. Roll it up, smoke it up. My old mama can't keep me from looking up. One ear out the other, one man out the smother. The neighborhood that left me here without my brother. Fuck you undercovers and you dirty motherfuckers. In the hood that still fuck without rubbers. Club hop, bar hop, car shop, nail shop. To the mall, spend it all. Why the hell not? What bills, what rent? Don't know what's spent. Why you care? Do you work for the government? Fuck it, homie, I'ma laugh now, cry later. Get your paper, we can laugh now, cry later. All you players, you can laugh now, cry later.
Laugh now, cry later. That's the name of this episode.
Laugh now, cry later. See, I'm a product of this urban decay. A nigga dying for tomorrow, but live for today. A nigga lie still in ball, and G's okay. Don't you tell these motherfuckers that my name is O'Shea. Cause I'ma fuck up my baby's credit. Let him regret it. 7 months old, he's already got a jail record. I'm the one to blame. Put it in my mama's name. She's a drama queen, but I got the bling bling. I need the watch and the bracelet and the earrings. I need you all to show up at my hearings. Tell the judge I'm a nice nigga, good nigga. And I'ma play the sad face when he love nigga. Fuck it, homie, I'ma laugh now, cry later. Get your paper, we can laugh now, cry later. All you players, you can laugh now, cry later. Investigators, let you laugh now, cry later.
He got a whole nother minute 30 for you. If you're listening to this podcast, he got a whole nother minute 30 for you.
It's fucked up that y'all won't accept my calls. Tell mama at least she can send some draws. These walls make y'all forget about me. I'm coming home in 2033. But that's irrelevant. Did you get the mail I sent? What I tell her, bitch, you better stay celibate. She start lying to me, tell me who she ain't fucking. Never tell me that my homeboys ain't nothing. Bun in the oven, it belonged to my cousin. Got the nerve to tell me that you really love him. I'm a killer ass when a nigga make parole. Hit her with my cane cause a nigga brand old. Fuck it, homie, I'ma laugh now.
Cry later.
Get your paper, we can laugh now.
Cry later.
All you players, you can laugh now. Cry later. Investigators, let you laugh now. Cry later.
That's what I'm on.
I like it.
Rondo Show Podcast episode 135. I appreciate you, man.
Bro.
Thank you for fucking doing this, bro. You a fucking god. Peace out there. Appreciate you.
Unifying my people, religions, only the bitches. Niggas trying to grow so divisions. Ain't in the bitches. Standing on my bar so the prisons can never hit up. My rough, rugged rhymes. That nigga fucked with the greatest of all time. There's no other contender.